Ready?
Yeah.
It's.
Pig Sooie, Razorback.
Well, you gotta do it three times. So it's.
Okay.
Pig Sooie.
Pig Sooie.
Now we do the Razorbacks.
Pig Sooie, Razorbacks.
So now you know how to do it. Yeah. So it's on the third one. It's the Razorbacks.
Okay.
So.
You would throw in something hard.
You got it. If you're coming to Arkansas, you got to know how to call. Yeah. We're just trying to help you out here.
Oh, I hear you.
Right. So.
I am going to use that like you will not believe tonight. Thank you. You know, finding a rhyme for Fayetteville might be easier, actually. Thank you for showing that to me. Yes, sir. Hey, Brett. Yeah, it is. So I went to school at Oklahoma State right across the line here with a kid named Brian Petrie. Brian Petrie was just a cowboy kind of kid from Edmond, Oklahoma. And we're going through school together. I ran into him down in Houston after we had got a record deal. Ran into him down at the lumber yard down in Texas. I said, what are you doing? He says, I'm installing sprinkler systems. I said, you like it? He goes, mm-hmm. I said, we're looking for our very first crew member. Would you ever think of it? I said, yeah. Brian Petrie now runs the whole ship. So we've known each other for 100 years, trust each other. He was here last Sunday. He'll be the guy that's here till Tuesday. And he'll immediately go to LSU, where the first stages will be set up again for the next weekend. This be gone for 4 months and not see his family. It's where you put your faith in your people. And so with Brian Petrie, I'll put him up against anybody. So I get to go home, kind of enjoy what I do. I'll go in the studio. I think we're doing the National Geographic voiceover this week, which is going to be tons of time in the studio while he is down, usually in pouring rain, trying to put stuff up and hoping that it doesn't rain for the weekend. And so it's a massive undertaking on somebody else's part. 56 trucks moving down there, so you got 56 drivers that all are family and you're trying to take care of. But at the same time, business is a business, so once those drivers drop off, then they go to work during the week doing other stuff, then come back for our gear as well. So it's a well-oiled and well-tuned machine that I wouldn't even know how to begin to tell you how it works. All I know is I get to eat dessert. I get to show up like today, get to learn how to call the hogs, right? Tonight we'll do a sound check for the lighting guys. We'll do our sound check this afternoon right after this. Then tonight we'll do the lighting where everybody focuses in on the lighting. And then tomorrow we'll do a sound check just for the fun of it, but and set up your opening acts. And then here'll come the show. And I'm telling you right now, anybody that stands gets to be the artist that says in this business you have to work, don't believe them one bit. This is the greatest joy that you can have. I doubt this will be legal in another 10 years, so I'm enjoying it now. Everybody good? Yes, sir. Oh, I'm sorry.
I saw you in Chicago 23 years ago.
Okay.
You were flying on the ropes. Do you still do that?
No. You kidding me? It was probably the old Rosemont Arena that was there, which I love that place. We launched our comeback tour in 2014 after we came out of retirement at what was the old Rosemont Arena, now the Allstate building, I think, might have been. Chicago's always been a great place for us. But, yeah, so if you're coming to the show tonight, I hope there's something. It's like artists. Like when James Taylor does a record now, you want something new from James, but you want that old thread that makes why you loved him in the first place in there. I hope when you come to the show, you go, hey, the same guys, they haven't changed, but at the same time, hopefully there's something new about it. And that's our job as entertainers. But thank you for the trip to Chicago. Yes, ma'am? Mel?
Yeah.
L. Did she say Yael? Yael. Yael, okay. Well, try to remember that I live with maybe one of the greatest artists, singers on the planet. So forget the fact whether you're female or male, but I'm thinking she's a female. So my thing is just get ready. She's going to have to work 100 times more than any guy to get a tenth as much. But Reba, Trisha, Dolly, they don't care. They just roll up their sleeves. Go, you want to be outworked? Watch. And they just go to work. She's got to get to Nashville if she wants to do country, or L.A. if she wants to do pop, New York. You can't do it over YouTube and stuff. So I always encourage them to come there. Is she around your age? Because you seem very young, so Nashville would be perfect for her. It's a perfect place. It's kind of boiling over right now, and it's going to be that way for the next 10 years. Very loving town, starting to be very diversified. So I'd suggest, and we need new blood there always, so just go after it. Especially, man, if you're not married, you don't have kids, and you're free, go find out, because the worst life that you can live, not the worst life, but a life you don't want to live is just a what-if life, right? Go find out. Tell her good luck. All right, thank you guys for being so sweet. Are we going to do the one-on-ones now?
Yeah.
All right, thank you all.